folks, Rich here at RC Informer. Today I have one of the newer planes coming from Free Wing and Motion RC. This is their 90mm F-18C Hornet. I'm going to be showing you the one in the Blue Angels colors. It also comes in gray. I had a real good opportunity to fly this thing at NOLL in the fall last couple weeks. Flew it with Wesley Miller and at Mary Boozer. Also flew with James. I flew James's plane actually at Motion RC. Retweaked the flight control, so I'll have a lot to talk about with this, but I'll be throwing up some pictures with all of us out there flying the airplane and stuff. And then I'll be putting those throughout the video, front and back and so forth. But this is a really nice model. You notice down here it does say 90 or 80 and 92 in one. So it actually comes with a little shim thing for a smaller size fan. If you want to go maybe with a higher performance 80 millimeter and just make it an 80 millimeter, that's fine. But I'll show you that in the box. Also, wingspan on this baby is about 1 meter, a little over. The length of it is 1,500 millimeters, and I'm going to reach over this thing right here, guys. I'm going to pull off the top here and just show you the specs on this deal, and we'll get in it and I'll show you everything about it. On the side of the box here, guys, we've got all the specs on it. It's a 9-blade 90 millimeter. Comes with a 1750 kV brushless outrunner. This is going to be stock. 130 amp ESC with a 8 amp UBEC. 217 gram digital servos, 9 gram digital metal gear servos, all metal gears. And of course, the landing gear doors open. Lights all the way around it, so it's nice. Electric retracts, and requires a basically a 5,000 milliamp pack, which is the standard we all use. So I'll be getting into detail on this thing and showing you the inside and my setup, because I did set mine up a little bit differently than stock. And I'll be showing you that, guys, as I get into the flight demos and setup. But for here, you can see what's inside the box. Really nice packaging all the way around. Everything's bagged, so it's real nice in there. Of course, right on top here, off the bat, we got the instruction manual, which I'll show you that probably a little bit towards the end. And then the decal packages. Since this is the Hornet, the Blue Angels Hornet, all the decals are on it except for the 1, 2, 3, 4. And then, of course, you can put the Blue Angels logo on there. So I'll figure out whether I'm going to be 1 through 7. We'll see. Sometimes number 1, I like to be the lead. 2 and 3 are the wings. 4 is the slot. 5 and 6 are the solo and opposing solo. And then 7, I think, is one of the training planes they use, or twin seaters usually, for the Hornets. But you see the numbers there, so you get your choice of putting the number that you want on the airplane, which is cool. So you can get together, fly with your friends in formation, and hopefully we'll do that at next NOLL in the fall. But you can see here clearly, guys, how nicely this thing is laid out. And I'm going to show you pretty much pretty standard for Free Wing stuff is to double box everything. Okay, and then here, this is what I'm going to show you guys real fast. You can see here, this is that the cowling or the shim for the 80, and it even says right there for the 80 millimeter. So that will fit into the fuselage somewhere. If you should choose that you would like to do a 80 millimeter as opposed to the 90 that actually comes in this thing. So let me see if I can pull the tape off and show you how this thing looks. The top and the bottom half, you can see your fuselage all laid out there real nice. You got your wing panels there. Those are your horizontals there. Your vertical stabilizers are there, nose cone right down there. And I think that's one of the hatches. And then there's your canopy right there. So, but overall, real nice layout in the box. Again, typically double-deckered box from Free Wing, and really nice. So let's get all the parts out, we'll lay them out, and we'll take a closer look at everything in greater detail. Here's the layout of all the parts that came out of the box, minus, of course, the decals that stickers that we just looked at. And this is the 80 millimeter cowl and insert. So if you were to get an ARF Plus version of this airplane, or you wanted to turn this into an 80, I don't know why you'd want to take the 90 out and put an 80, but some guys might want to do that. This is your insert that goes inside the airframe, and this is your new hatch cover that goes on the underside to accommodate and fit perfectly your 80 millimeter fan. So it's nice that they include that. I'm gonna put those aside and we'll take a look at the rest. Very concise, very simple, very high quality airplane. This is awesome. I don't think I'm gonna do any kind of a build or assembly guide, guys, unless I come into a problem with this thing. I flew the one that James had at Motion RC at NOLL in the fall, and it's just an awesome performing airplane. And it looks like it's gonna go together with 2 each wing screws with your main spar right there. I think there's about 3 screws per rudder, and then there's about 2 or 3 screws or whatever to put your elevators, your horizontals, onto the output shafts there. And you got your wingtip missile rails, which are really nice on this plane. I'm going to show you those closer because they're all kind of covered in plastic, and they're very durable in the event that you scrape a wing, which you can because the landing gear is a little narrow on this airplane. And then you get your nose cone, which is magnets on, and a few parts here that I'll show you, details that you glue on, and push rods and horns and stuff. But this is a sweet airplane, guys. It should go together really easy. So James at Motion RC, I think he had an assembly guide on this that you can go with. I'm mostly going to be, which is pretty easy to do again, mostly I'm going to be focused on the setup, where the rods and horns go to make it fly a little better, because I thought the stock setup was great. It just needed to be adjusted and set up properly to fly well. So I'll show you what I did with mine. But in the meantime, let's take a look at each of these parts in closer detail so I can really show you a lot of the finer details and finer points of everything. Okay, the first part up to show you guys is the main fuselage. This thing is long and thin, and it's nice because it's mostly one piece. I got it leaning on the tail because it is a little difficult to handle here on the camera, but I'll be picking it up shortly. I figured I'd start off here with the nose cone, which really, it just magnets in place. You can see the two magnets with a little plywood bulkhead there. If you ever needed to add nose weight, it would be easy enough to do to this airplane, but you can see how easy it just sticks right in place. There is a little bit of paint missing, I know you can see right here. That's probably just from the box, but I'll probably go match this paint over at Lowe's and just touch this up a little bit so that all will disappear. But you can see how nicely that fits in place. It just magnets on. And again, I'm going to take it off just to make this thing a little bit easier to maneuver. I'm going to go ahead and pick this thing up and show it all to you in some real nice detail. They did a beautiful job on this thing. The quality on this thing is awesome. I would have liked to have seen some plastic leading edge extensions on this, because you could dent this pretty easily, but it is thick enough that it's not too bad. Just got to be careful handling that, because you could dent this and sort of ruin the finish. But we all know foam is extremely easy to fix. Another couple of details I want to show you guys. Plastic, and this is what I wanted them to do to leading edge extensions, plastic leading edge lips, inlet lips. So you will not damage these at all. These are plastic. You can see the edge where they are. So they did a beautiful job on that intake. I'll see if we can look down in there, see a piece of the fan. It's kind of hard to see all that. And then let's go down the side here and look at the quality of the lenses of the lights on here. They've painted around the edge of the lights. It looks really sharp, really professional. Here's the one on the other side as well. There are some plastic details I think that fit in right here and I think right there that I'll show you in the little parts bag that comes with this thing. There's a little bit of pass-through air, and then as we go along the side, you can see your plastic fittings for your wing screws, your pass-through hole for your main wing spar, which is right down there. It just passes right through. And then you got your two metal screw threads. So you put your metal screws in, you make your connection, put your spar in, make your two wing screws, just like you see the wing down there, and it bolts right in place. So a very, very simple design all the way around. Same thing with your horizontal or your vertical stabilizers. They plug right in. It looks like 1, 2, and 3 screws. You can see right down there, and we'll take a closer look at those as I get to that and start showing you that. The underside of the plane is pretty awesome too. Cheater hole right down in there. You can see your speed controller down there through the louvers. And landing gear doors that open up real nice, and I don't think I can get in there because they're sort of mechanically driven. I think they're spring loaded, but they're still, the main gear holds those in. You can see your hatch cover 4 screws for your 90 millimeter fan. And then along the back side here, you can see your shaft for your elevators and your service for your elevators, and there's just a plastic cover that goes over that. So we'll attach the push rod onto that, get those babies connected, and we'll get it set up. And here's where I'm pretty sure I use the innermost hole to get the right throw out of it. And we'll talk about that part a little later when I do the setup of the airplane in a future video here. I think I used the inner hole to get all the throw out of it that we needed. And that gave me really good resolution on the servo. And your exhaust pipes here in the back, really nicely detailed, folks. Nice plastic fittings all the way around. Let me see if I can get the nose of this on the ground so we can look down there. You can see your 90 millimeter fan way down in there, sorta. And this may be a good candidate. I'm going to see if I can get some of Guniac's afterburners in this thing. See if I can get them to get me a twin one to put back in there, a single that goes off into both sides, and we'll kind of take a look. I think there's some antennas that go back here. There is a light here as well. Very nice lens cover, but all the way around, the fit and finish of this thing is pretty awesome overall. There is a tail hook that we're going to glue onto the back of this thing, but I'm just liking this. This is my first look at this, guys. I always show you guys this first look just as I see it too, so I can kind of give you my take on my first impressions on this whole thing. So got your mechanical latch here, which I'll pop open here. You can see you got a nice little wood doubler there, sort of, that acts as a stop. There is a wood doubler up front in the tongue section to make sure that that thing's tough. And we got a screwed in or screwed up pilot in there. There he is. So he's all in there, a little bit of an instrument panel. And as we look inside of this thing, you can see that they've got some shelf liner with double stick tape. Where did they get that idea from? That's really a good idea. They must have been watching my videos. That's all right, we'll keep it a secret. Wait a minute, this is on video, so it's not really a secret. I've been doing this on my planes for years, and I know folks have been watching. This is a really good way to secure your batteries without Velcro. Is just some shelf liner with double stick tape below it. They got it a little crooked on there, so I'll probably pull it off the floor and line it up straight and get it in there. But that really secures your batteries in place. I will probably throw a second battery strap in that other slot that's back there, so I got two, so I can fly inverted and do all that kind of stuff with it without doing an inverted battery bomb drop out of the thing. And then you can see there's a carbon rod running through there for some strength. You see your BEC right there sitting next to your EC5 connector and some light wires. And there's your kind of blue junction box down in there. So plenty of room for a battery. You could probably even go 8-cell if you want, but you definitely can put a large size 6-cell if you need to. But 5,000 is really all you need. I found the 5,000 Admiral was nice and small fit in there. But you could probably put a 55 or 6,000 or 62 or whatever you want in there. But overall fit and finish of this thing is outstanding. I know that a lot of guys are painting this thing in a gloss. I think they're using that paint from Lowe's. I forgot what it was, clear coat gloss kind of paint over it. And that's probably a good way to go if you want that Blue Angel shine. I may or may not do that. I'm probably gonna leave mine like this. It's sort of a flat, sort of almost, actually like a semi-gloss. Just because I think when you ding it, it's gonna be easier to fix. If you got a gloss finish and you ding it, it's gonna be harder to finish it, and then you gotta gloss it again, and just kinda, it's just gonna leave like a kind of a shell over it. It might be tougher to fix. But anyway, the overall stock finish is nice. One more thing I was gonna show you here. I'm just gonna flip this over without dropping the thing, because it is kinda big. The nose gear, I really can't get in there that well because it is a mechanically driven door by the strut, but you can see all aluminum strut down in there and wheel and everything, all ready to go. So those doors open and close real nice, and overall fit and finish, like I said, folks, this thing is really a sweet model. What I decided to do for you guys in this next clip is it would be a crime to not show you guys the landing gear on this plane, because it is pretty sweet. So I took my Turnigy servo tester, just plugged in a 4.8 volt battery, and we are going to take a look at the landing gear, and it's in full operation here, because it is pretty nice stuff. I'll go ahead and set it going, and you can see how nice everything comes out. I literally just plugged this thing in. You can see they're using almost the same mechanism here for the the landing gear mount that you can see down in here for the F-14, and they have this beautiful kind of scissor link mechanism here, spring loaded. So you don't need an additional servo to drive the doors open and closed. You have a nice landing light on there. And then as we get back to the main gear, you can see how robust this stuff is. I'll go ahead and flex this for you. I'm working here hard on the camera for you guys because it's tough to move all this stuff. But you can see this is some really ultimate F-18 landing gear. You can see the door mechanism here. Again, no servos needed. It has this ingenious mechanism here that the gear just touches as it goes in, and it's spring-loaded to stay open. So you can see really how nice this thing is. I'll go ahead and cycle it again, the main gear here, so you guys can really see how nice this thing works. It's a little bit on a delay, but we'll see how this goes back in there. Just absolutely fantastic how nice this is. Now, one more time, we'll do this on the nose gear so you guys get a better view of how nice this thing operates. Again, it's a little bit of a delay here, but here we go. Simply awesome landing gear overall. Now, one thing I did notice is the mount does seem to be a little bit, like it leaves a little bit more support in there if you're gonna use this thing on grass. And I will be getting to that, so I'll be showing you, just stay tuned to RC Informer, and I'll be showing you some upgrades just to make that nose gear a bit tougher, or at least the landing gear mount for it a little bit tougher. I think the mains are plenty tough enough. It looks like they're in there pretty good, but overall, folks, just fantastic landing gear on this Freewing 90mm F-18. The next main part up to show you guys is the main wing panel. Once again, fit and finish is superior. Very, very nice. You can see here how the spar fits right into the slot. Again, that passes through. And then you've got your multi-pin connection that connects your, if there's any lights out on the end. I'm not sure if there are lights out here. I don't think there is. But it does connect your ailerons and your flaps and any other thing that is out here. That just plugs right in. You can see the wire sticking out. And then you just put this thing right on in. Nice carbon far, very tight fit in there. So it's not wiggling around or anything. So real nice on that. And then as we look in here, you can see these plastic fittings. Very, very nicely manufactured, very, very nicely glued in place as well, and then painted over. So just really impressed. Got the US Navy decals on the bottom, and you can see your servos, your metal ball links right there. All the servos are in there and ready to go. Screw in hatch covers, so if you have to do a servo replacement, you can. And then there you can see really nice offset flap hinges as well. So you can see how nicely those flaps come down. They are slotted, so air passes through, goes over through the slot in there, helps joins with the top air, helps generate a bunch more lift. So really nice flaps. Landing with this airplane was really a pleasure to do because it does have a nice flap system on it, and the hinges are done real nice. I probably would have liked to have seen more or less a submerged style hinge on this instead of a traditional type like this, but there are plastic hinges in there, standard Freewing ones that work really well. And then one part that I really want to talk about right here in particular is this missile rail. This was sweet. This saved me once or twice when I was flying the Motion RC plane that James flies there at Motion. I was flying his plane, like I said, at Knoll in the fall the whole time. But this thing is partially foam around the round edge, but the bulk of it is actually plastic. So you can see if you ever land this thing, which F-18s, you can see down in the picture, that has kind of narrow gear, and you turn while you're going too fast in the landing roll, or even slowing after the touchdown landing roll, or even the takeoff roll, it can flip up on two wheels and scrape a wingtip. Well, it's not a problem with this airplane because this is all plastic. You can see how nice this is. You don't wear it out. I mean, you might scrape some of the paint off it, but you're not going to damage it. And then, of course, it all fits in there. You can see with a really nice plastic fitting all the way around. I don't know if there's a right way or a wrong way to put these, but also it does have a slot here. These two slots right here, because it's a missile rail, meant to put a missile on. No missiles come with this because Blue Angels don't carry missiles, but the gray version of the airplane does, I'm assuming it probably comes with missiles, or there's an optional missile packet that comes with it or something. But two screws put this missile rail on, and this, by far, is probably the finest missile rail that I have seen on a foam fighter plane ever. It's just such a good design because they made it tough out of plastic, and it can handle scrape in the ground. So, but anyway, you can also see here on the flap, the internal, more or less internal ball link in there where the rod goes. You do have to put the rods on this plane, of course, but not a big deal. Nice channel for it all the way around. But overall, folks, really impressed with the wings on this airplane. The next parts up to show you guys are the horizontal stabilizer right here, or flying tail, and the vertical stabilizer and the rudder. You can see here, again, traditional type hinges, none of the submerged style stuff. I would have liked to have seen that, but that does make the cost of the airplane more, so it's actually kind of nice that they did it more or less the traditional way. Really nice plastic fittings, one screw there, a second one here, and a third one here, so three screws get this on, plus your connector that you want to put on for your rudder control. You do have to put your rod and linkage clevis on there, a ball link I should say. But nice fit and finish all around, and here's where one of your decals goes. You can either put a 1-7 on here and choose your position in the formation of Blue Angels airplane. So anyway, guys, the horizontal stabilizer is real nice as well. It's just one piece. Fit and finish is nice. Spar through the middle for rigidity. These are not opposing or stabilators where they act as ailerons too. They are actually just elevators up and down. However, you could program and separate the servos, mess with that if you guys want to. It may augment the roll, but the flying I did of the airplane, it just really didn't need it. But that simplifies the programming or the lack of programming needed to set this thing up. But overall, really nice tail components on this plane. Here's the last few parts just to show you guys. Here's the gaggle parts bag here of screws to get everything in place. The rods, horns, linkages, ball links, keepers, all that kind of stuff. So L-bend keepers. And it's pretty straightforward how these things go on. And then, of course, a separate parts bag here. You've got a little thing of contact cement in case you don't want to use foam tack, but I use foam tack for everything. These are your two elevator covers that cover down that lower rear quarter and one on each side. They're just plastic covers. They're very easy to get on and off with foam tack. And then a few other parts here. I'm not sure what some of these things are. Obviously, these are the vortex generators or these pieces that go on the front edge of the fuselage. I think they go right there. And they're painted up in the Blue Angels livery there with the yellow band around the blue. And then a couple of pitot tubes and stuff to glue into place. A couple fins, a couple navigation, ILS, radio, VHF, comm antennas, that kind of stuff. So really nice parts package all around. And then here's there's a tail hook right there. So pretty complete set, just a small detail stuff to put on the airplane. And then, of course, what I'm using in most all my free wing stuff nowadays, the Admiral receivers. You just can't beat these for the price. I don't even remember what these were. 10 channels, like $30 or $40 or something, and satellite, I don't remember what those were, but just a great inexpensive way to get a DSMX, you know, receiver in your plane. Motion's making some of the nicest and really cost-effective, affordable stuff out there and so forth. So overall, folks, just a really nice parts bag on this airplane. Last but not least is the instruction manual, and as we go through this, there's a part here for the, that's in Chinese, I can't read that, the multifunction control box, which has been the subject of many discussion, and those have worked well for me so far. Haven't had any major problems with those. I've heard some people have, but I don't see a problem with them. They seem to be working okay for me, but overall, you can see the instruction manual here shows the parts, which we just talked about. You just got to put your, this is designed if you're really going to assemble the entire thing together, I think. Or no, actually this one does show pretty much putting it together, I think, the way you put it together. This just shows, you know, your wings going on, your spar, your connections, your tail, hatch covers you can see right there, putting your stabilizers on, your vertical stabilizers on. Where your battery goes, real basic nose cone. Oh, there's your antennas, pitots, and your nose cone antenna. So a couple few antennas back there. I probably missed those in the bag just because they're kind of small, so in there, but they're in there, I'm pretty sure. Rods, horns, linkages, I'm gonna talk more about that later. I don't wanna go into all that too much detail because I put mine in a different place and I think the plane flies better. 88 millimeters for the CG, I'll talk about that again. When we get to the flight demo part, look for that in the flight demo video I'll put out. I'll talk about that and where I set everything up to fly better, I think, or where I think the plane did fly best. And that's it. This is the Chinese part that I cannot read. So overall, real nice, folks. Really impressed with the stuff coming from Free Wing and Motion RC. We'll be slapping this together. It'll go together quick. We'll be getting it out to the field, me and Steve, and giving you guys some demo flights of it as well. Just superior airplane. I am of the mindset of Alpha over at Motion RC. I know he's wanted to make an F-18C Hornet 90mm for a long time, and I've kind of waited for one for a long time to come out. I used to fly the old StarMax stuff, which isn't even in business anymore. This just blows the doors off of that or anything else that kind of was out there. Real easy to put together, nice fit and finish, flies fantastic. It's very fast, but it'll slow down nice and slow for a nice touchdown. So be checking for the flight demo videos. We'll be getting those out here as quick as we can. Appreciate you guys liking and subscribing to RC Informer. Keeps me going. Thanks for the comments. Keep the comments rolling. Appreciate you guys watching RC Informer. And as always, guys, we will see you next time.